Hey, this is Oksana Boychenko with you today, and I have a real special treat for you today. So I have a girl who is actually arriving to the United States very, very soon, permanently relocating to the United States. She is absolutely stunning, gorgeous. I seriously, she looks like a model. But this girl, additionally to her beauty qualities, she is a successful business person. She has a very giving and open heart. She is volunteering in a different like charity events and things like that. So this is a combination of beauty, grace, brain. It's like 100% that anybody would be wishing for in his woman. So let me introduce you, Ksenia, and stay tuned until the end of this video, because we're actually going to be using some of the uncut footage that was recorded during the interview, and that's going to be lots of fun. Who is this beauty here today with us? Can you introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Ksenia. I'm from Ukraine.
Which city in Ukraine are you at?
Sumy.
Okay. All right. And have you been to the United States before?
No, actually. I'm waiting when I come.
Yeah, so basically, we can switch to Russian if it is easier for you. I know you speak a little bit of English, but I know you're a little bit nervous right now, and that is okay.
If you don't mind.
Yeah, I'm on the camera all the time, but for the people who are the first time on the camera, of course, it is a little bit uncomfortable. So you can speak Russian. I will translate, okay? All right. Okay, so you're from Ukraine, but you have... Tell me about your family situation. Your family actually lives in the United States, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I usually cannot recognize that. It's my mom and more than me. Mm-hmm.
So Ksenia's family lived in the United States in California. They live here for 17 years. And Ksenia, she lives in Ukraine, but her document is about to be approved to get the status for the family reuniting. So it's like a matter of just maybe a month or so, right? Okay, all right. So you know about the life in the United States because you have your family, your mom, and your brother living here.
My mama мне много рассказывала о тех местах, где она жила. Это было несколько штатов. Ой, Калифорния. Она все время жила в Калифорнии, только меняла города.
Okay. Your mom lived in different cities in California, right? Like different places. Okay. All right. So tell me, I know that you are traveling to Europe all the time, right? You haven't been to the United States, but you're traveling to Europe.
Sometimes, yes, I travel. And to Europe, the country. I like this. I like new place, new town, new feelings. It's very interesting.
Mm-hmm. How about let's talk about your professional background. I was really amazed of how many different fields you work at. But let's talk about your education. Where did you graduate from?
My first education is the Bankovska Academia, I'm an economist.
Mm-hmm. So, Ksenia is by education, and she is it is basically a banking field academy of she graduated from the academy.
Я работала в банке несколько лет. Затем я поменяла свой профиль и открыла агентство недвижимости. Это было мой личный бизнес.
So Ksenia, she worked in the banking field for a few years, and then she understood that she had so much more potential. And so she decided to go in a different direction. And so she opened her own business, which is a real estate agency, which was quite successful, right?
Yes. Yeah. This business было у меня 7 лет. И это был очень интересный опыт. И я наслаждалась своей работой. Мне это нравилось.
So you started everything from ground zero in that business. You bought the building, you did the repair, you like started everything from zero, and you've had that business successfully developing for 7 years. And so then what happened with that business?
У меня появился маленький ребенок. И в связи с этим я решила оставить этот бизнес, так как нужно было вкладывать не очень времени, много сил.
Yeah.
Поэтому я отдала предпочтение этому сыну.
So then surprise happened, and Ksenia found out that she's going to be a mom. And so she had to make a choice, because the real estate business, and because she was working there very actively, it was a full-time job, and that required lots of time. So she had to make a choice between being a mom or being a business owner. So she sold her business, and so she's a proud mom now. So you decided not to hire the babysitters. You decided to devote all your time to your baby, correct?
Right.
And how did it turn out? How old is your son now?
My son 18.
Yes. So Ksenia devoted 3 years of her life raising as a single parent, raising her son. Her son is 8 years old now, and he is quite an achiever. What is your son's name?
Zahar.
All right. Okay. So he's a what is the sport that he's involved in? Because he's like a champion already, right? He's a champion.
Champion in Ukraine. It's a free fighter.
Free fighter? So it's like wrestling, like a free. Okay. All right. Okay. So when he was 3 years old, you decided to, since the baby already was somewhat, you know, not independent, but still you had a little bit more time, you decided to open another business, or you decided to go in a different sphere, which is massage therapy.
Я занялась этим, потому что я могу распределять свое время. Это очень интересно, и я получаю удовольствие от того, что могу помогать людям.
How many certificates and diplomas do you have in the massage therapy now?
10.
10. Okay, that is very interesting. You gotta hear this. Ksenia decided, because she has so much love in her heart and she has really fantastic energy and very strong hands in terms of like massaging and everything. So she decided to try herself in a different sphere, and which is a massage therapy. Now she has 10 certificates of like different level of the massages. And so which was your first certificate that you receive? Because now I know that you can do like relaxation massage, you can do like deep tissue massage, you can do recovery massages, you can do like all these different levels of them, like a beauty massage as well, right? But what did you start?
Первый сертификат был классический массаж для тела, абсолютно все тело, это классический массаж, расслабляющий.
So the first certificate that she received, it was a classical massage, it's a full body relaxation massage. Yeah, so now all of the, you know, everybody who is watching right now, like, I'm in line, please, please give me a massage. No, this is a science. This is, the type of things that massage therapists are doing, they are giving lots of energy. They are taking lots of energy on themselves, but they are also giving lots of energy. Do you feel that you have lots of energy to give like a positive and healing energy to the person that you are working with?
Yeah, это очень самый важный момент, когда ты делаешь массаж, ты должен отдавать очень хорошую энергию. Я ее получаю тоже от многих вещей в жизни, поэтому я с удовольствием ее дарю и надеюсь, что мои клиенты это чувствуют и всегда приходят и возвращают.
Yeah, so Ksenia said that one of the most important things for the really good massage therapist is to give healing and healing energy. And that is what Ksenia has. You know, she has that healing energy that she is giving to, to the clients. So do you feel that you would want to have something like this in the future?
Конечно, я хотела бы получить лицензию в Америке. Я открыть какой-то свой салон, бьюти-салон и заниматься этим делом дальше. Мне это нравится.
It doesn't make sense for you to open that really full salon business in Ukraine right now, because you're moving to United States in just a couple of months or so, right? So you have all this, experience and everything else, but you feel like this is your field. This is the field that you really enjoy working in. And that's something that you think would be a really great idea for you to do in the United States, to have your own like massage salon or something like that, right? Okay. Well, you know, I personally don't know too many massage therapists who have so many diplomas as you do, that experience in all of the all of the fields like this of the body. Okay, fantastic. With the type of giving person like you are, do you participate in any like charity life or any donations?
Да, у нас есть небольшой проект, который собирает средства для маленьких детей. Они находятся в этом доме малютки, возрасте 5 лет, и мы собираем деньги раз в год на праздник и отдаем их сюда. Это поддержка.
Mm-hmm. So Ksenia, she belongs to a group. It is actually a really close group of their friends, but this group is growing all the time. And this group, they put the funds together, and they are collecting, you know, they are buying different things for their orphan homes. But this is like for, this is for the babies. This is for the babies that are under 3 years old. So there's like special places in Ukraine and Russia. So and you are doing those type of events specifically on a certain day. It is what Saint Nicholas. Why is that day so special?
Потому что в этот день именно маленьким детям дарят подарки, ложат их под подушку, и они просыпаются с хорошим настроением и чувством какого-то волшебства.
So Saint Nicholas Day is in December, and this is the day when the kids are getting the gift that being put under their pillows, while they're sleeping. So when they wake up, they get all these different gifts and everything. So it is it's kind of a religious holiday, I guess, in some way, right? So Ksenia is Leo by horoscope, and so Leos, of course, I mean, they like meat, but Leos is like one of the, I wouldn't say the best, but it's like a really, really great sign of horoscope, because Leos are very faithful, they are very loyal, they really will kill for their pack, you know, so they will fight for the family, and the faithfulness level, it's especially developed in Leos. But Leos, they also like to take care of others. They are very extremely giving people. That is, they're probably the sign of horoscope that is the most giving. So that explains the personality of Ksenia as well. Yeah? So you basically, you are kind, you are giving, you give a lot. I know you are in an absolutely fantastic physical shape as well. How do you stay so gorgeous? Tell me.
Мою физическую форму я поддерживаю в спортзале. Обязательно для меня. Стараюсь есть хорошие продукты, правильные. Хотя я очень люблю мясо.
So Ksenia is saying that she, yeah, of course, she works out in gym several times a week, and so she stays in a good shape and. But she's like, you know what, I do like to eat, and I do like to eat meat. How about seafood? Do you like seafood as well?
Yeah.
So, what else do you like to do?
Я люблю очень многие вещи. Я люблю отдых, я люблю какие-то новые места, я люблю развиваться в любых направлениях, те, которые доставляют физическое и моральное развитие. Это многие вещи, которые присутствуют в моей жизни. Стараюсь этим заниматься.
Yeah, so Ksenia, she loves to learn new things. She loves to travel. She loves to develop in the different directions. I know that she is also into like stretching. It is some kind of so it's basically like stretching your body, and it is some kind of things from the like ceiling, and that you are pulling yourself like in all the different things, so like spread everywhere, stretching everywhere.
Yes, you're right.
That's great. How about cooking? Do you like to cook?
Очень люблю готовить и делаю это с удовольствием. Меня к этому приучила еще мама с моего детства, и поэтому я развивалась в этом направлении. Знаю много видов разных.
So Ksenia, she loves to cook, and she said that, you know, it was actually engraved in me by my mom. So she knows different cuisines over different cuisines over different countries, and she likes to experiment. She likes to try different things, so she likes to experiment with the different things. You mentioned before that most of the things that you do in life, all of the things that you do in life, you do them quick. So you are not. You wouldn't be spending like 4 hours in the kitchen, you know, but you would do it straight to the point, boom, boom, quick and yummy. Do you read? Do you watch the movies? Do you like reading? And what type of, are you into art at all?
Я читаю классическую литературу, мне это нравится очень. Я читаю детективы, есть очень много литературы, связанной с моей работой, это технические моменты. Я стараюсь как-то это делать, но прохожу время.
So Ksenia, the type of books that she likes to read, she likes classical books and she likes detective books. And also, of course, she has to read the literature that is connected to her field where she is working in. How about movies, theaters, art? Are you into that?
Да, мне это тоже нравится. Я люблю хорошие фильмы. И особенно ходить в кинотеатр. Это другие ощущения.
Yeah, so Ksenia, she loves to go to the movies, she loves to go to the theaters, and she's into art as well. Okay. So Ksenia, how do you think you will be able to transform your man's life? What would he feel different when you enter in his life?
Давайте без работы. Я думаю, что я буду хорошим его другом. Понимаете, я всегда могу дать правильный совет. И защитить его от каких-то неприятностей в плане того, что я его чувствую. Я буду балансировать в этих отношениях правильно, стараться. Забота и внимание, женщина, это будет в принципе.
So Ksenia said, well, first of all, she's a very caring person. So, of course, all the care and support. And she's a very intuitive person as well, because, you know, energetically wise, she's very, very intuitive. So for her to bring that harmony and balance in his life, so she would even feel if he had a difficult day at work, you know, so with her, even with her healing energy, with the way that she is, she would balance all things out. And because she is a very caring and giving person, then of course the woman like this, like Ksenia, she would definitely bring all of the joy into your life. Ksenia, so a couple of words for that person who may be looking at you right now, a couple of words for that man. Can you tell him, you know, that special message coming from your heart?
Человеком, который знает, чего хочет, человеком-лидером, он должен быть ярким, он должен лечиться изнутри, его глаза, сердце, должна это чувствовать, видеть, и, естественно, быть мне опорой, защитой, и если это будет так, то я буду с ним на 100%, я для него.
So Ksenia said, I'm looking for the man who is a leader, a man who has a beautiful and giving world in his heart as well. Somebody who is the same way as I am, giving, kind, and open. Somebody who has that strength, somebody who has that core, somebody who knows what he wants, somebody who is achiever. And so this union, our union, will be growing together and we will be prospering. Fantastic, Ksenia, fantastic. And she also said, you know what, for this type of man who will give that care and love, I'm willing to give myself, you know, 100%, even 1,000%. Such doesn't exist, of course, 1,000%, but she is going to be 100% loyal, great friend, supporter, and of course, all the benefits that come with that. So look at this gorgeous, gorgeous, wonderful lady. Ksenia, thank you so much. Listen, we are waiting for you in United States very, very soon. So I know that your documents are already about to be approved. And I'm sure your family can't wait for your arrival here. You're probably already like ready to start packing and everything else, huh? Okay, so do you see what I mean? So this girl is going to be coming to the United States in just a matter of just a few months. Maybe her documents will be approved within a month or so, maybe a little bit longer, but it's definitely coming very, very soon. She's all already packing her suitcases, packing all the things. So she's coming very, very soon right here. So you got to grab her before somebody else did, because the girl like this will not stay single as soon as she gets to the United States. So let me know about your interest of meeting Ksenia, and I will be happy to get you guys introduced. So let me know my contact details right below this video. So listen, you are, can you just, how do you feel? A couple of words for that special person that may be looking at you right now. Just looking at you. Okay, она пошла его читать, зачем быть? Подготовилась. Она такая серьезная, листик берет. Сейчас, говорит, посмотрю, подожди.
Сейчас я еще и руку с подушки показываю, потом помочь.
Сейчас скажу.
Вот, собственно говоря.